Yeah. Yes, Lord, amen. Oh, see, this is how we overcome. This is how we overcome. This is how we overcome. See?
This is how we
overcome. This is how we overcome. Amen. Yes, yes, Lord. Yes, yes, Lord, amen. Yes, yes, Lord. Yes, yes, Lord.
Our Lord,
Oh.
pulling you out.
Matthew 28.
And we're going to read from verse 18. Matthew 28, verse 18. Hallelujah. So it says, "And Jesus said unto them, All authority in heaven and earth has been given unto me. Go therefore and make disciples. Make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, teaching them to observe all that I have commanded you. And behold, I am with you always, even unto the end of the age." Hallelujah. So there are two things I want to share from that scripture quickly. Number one, God says we should go out and make disciples, not converts. You know, there's a difference between a convert and a disciple. You know, the disciple, if you think about the old, you know, from Jesus' day, reading in context, when he said disciple, the 12 were his disciples, right? So a disciple and their master is basically someone that will follow or kind of mirror the life of their master, their leader, their teacher. You know? So they sit with the rabbi, they learn. A disciple actually lives with the rabbi. You know, if you think about the scripture, when the first two disciples met Jesus, the first thing they asked him, said, "Master, where are you living? Where are you staying?" Why did they ask the question? Because that's what disciples do. They stay with the teacher, they stay with their master or their rabbi till they get, you know, fully mature, and then they go and they start, you know, discipling other people. So the disciple, like Paul, for example, who was baptized, was trained under Gamaliel, right? So that's how it works. So Paul was trained as a Pharisee under Gamaliel because he was Gamaliel's disciple, and he also in turn would then disciple other people. But when he got converted, guess who he discipled? He discipled Timothy. He discipled Titus. You know, that's how it goes. So if you look at the scripture, Jesus discipled, he made 12 disciples, and here he was instructing them. He says, "Go and make other disciples. Don't want the converts." So I was sharing with the pastor the last time I came, I had a dream. And this was a funny thing. You know, for me, I dream a lot. I dream a lot when I'm conscious of the dream. You know, when I'm, sometimes I just kind of, oh, just forget the dream. But sometimes I'm like conscious and Lord speaks to me in my dreams. So for me, when God speaks to me, most of the time dreams are usually literal. Because I don't have too much time for all this interpretation. As God just says, this guy will get it. If I give him all those words, he won't understand what I'm saying. So God just says, just give him, tell him exactly what it is. So anyway, so when God speaks to me most of the time, in my dreams, they're literal. Usually, basically God gives me night vision. That's really what he gives me. Because when it's literal, it's more of a night vision. When it's an interpretation, when you need to interpret it, it's more of a dream. I need to interpret the meaning. So anyway, how about those dreams? Like in that dream, I was in a church, and God said, told me that you can tell the church that if they want to grow, if they want to see increase and multiplication, that within a year they should make it such that each person in that church should disciple one person. We're not saying two people. It says in a year, make it your aim, make it your goal to win one person to the Lord and disciple them. Or, you know, win somebody to the Lord and follow them up until they become established in the faith. That's your job. Just one person in 1 year. That's not difficult, is it? It's not hard. It's not. You just have one job. One disciple, one person through the year, and make sure they get established and they get struck, and they get grounded in the faith. Hallelujah. Praise God. Hallelujah. So that is the model. You know, and most of the time when we deviate from what the Bible model is, we run into problems. Because really that's what the Bible model is. It's discipleship. And usually discipleship means you are around that person, you are constantly checking up on that person. It's a two-way thing. Discipleship is not just the person, you know, the person disciple, it's actually feedback as well. You are also getting encouraged by someone else. So, you know, it goes both ways. Pastor Lambert is a very good, you know, for me, he was one of my mentors growing up as a Christian. You know, he knows that very well. Like years ago when I was still in the world, but one of the things that helped me, I would say today, the reason I'm standing here today, holding this microphone and talking about Jesus is because of discipleship. That is his honest truth. Because he knows the man of God, Pastor Brasubai, you know, that led him to the Lord, he just took me under his wings. And from the first week I got saved, I got born again, I was in a very rough place. I was in one of those bad, terrible places. But he just took me under his wings and he discipled me. And from that day I got saved. That was it. I was just excited. We didn't know what to call it, but that was what was going on. And for us it was easier because I was saved because we were on campus, we were in university those days. So we ate together, we were running around preaching the gospel, we were praying together, we had so many religions together. So many times we were just, you know, sitting in the room and we are all just, you know, breaking scripture. There's no Bible study. That's like every day was Bible study for us. You know, every day was a prayer meeting. There was no, like, obviously you go to prayer meeting, but every time we are together, we are praying, we are fasting, we are, you know, we're quoting scriptures, we are encouraging ourselves. Do you know, for me, I miss those days. In my mind, I miss those days because it was so easy to stand as a Christian. If you have problems, you have so many people around you, so many. If you fail, it will be a problem, right? Before that, seriously, you have so much encouragement. You saw many people when they left university fail because they didn't have that support. Because when you're in university, those days in school, there was so many people around you to help you stand, you know? So I'm here today because of that time of 3 years working together with brethren, encouraging ourselves, picking ourselves up. Yes, you are with somebody here to encourage you. You don't have money to eat, another person is there to help you. You know, we're just helping each other mentally, spiritually, physically, financially. You know, even in our academics, we're helping each other as well.